Now, my colleague, we continue topic differentiation of tonsillitis. Now we will speak about differentiation of tonsillitis and infection mononucleosis. Next topic is infection mononucleosis. Those infection, endogenic infection, which caused by virus Epstein-Barr with iatrogenic mechanism of transmission, which caused the clinic of the fever, intoxication, syndrome of tonsillitis, lymphadenopathia, and gepatosplenomegaly. Epstein-Barr virus infected of 90% of population of the world. It is a kinds of herpes virus, type of gamma herpes virus, DNA virus, and the size of the virus is 120 and 150 nanometer. Activation, the virus cause activation proliferation of B lymphocytes. It connection with receptor of B lymphocytes and cause those proliferation. Iatrogenic and contact mechanism of transmission, maybe sexual and blood transfusions. Virus persistence in patients more than 80 months after primary infection, and in 15 and 25% of the patients cause the carriers of infection. The patients more than 40 years old all infected virus Epstein-Barr. Adult patients, yes. And the patient, the children, child patients from 1 month up to 6 months have passive immunity from those infection. And in the children less than 3 years old, they cause the formation of clinic influenza, flu-like syndrome. And the children in the age from 3 up to 30 years old cause the clinic of mononucleosic-like syndrome. The fever, tonsillitis, intoxication, lymphadenopathia, and gepatosplenomegaly. То есть in different patients cause different clinic forms of infection, maybe flu-like forms in the patients with less 3 years. It is a clinic of infection mononucleosis more than 3 years old. And maybe passive immunity after in the children after burning in the children from 1 up to 6 months have passive immune response. It is maternity antibodies, antibodies from organism of their mothers. Let's speak about pathogenesis of infection mononucleosis. You see, it is the virus with connect with receptor of B lymphocytes, and it causes the proliferation of B lymphocytes. Proliferation, transformation of B lymphocytes to plasmatic cells. Plasmatic cells. Plasmatic cell synthesis, immunoglobulin M, and those proteins cause agglutination of erythrocyte. It is used for diagnostic of those infection. Then activation of the suppressors, suppressor of B lymphocytes, and it causes the depression of proliferation of B lymphocytes, increasing of immunodeficiency syndrome. And the lymphocytes cause the formation of atypical mononuclears, and it causes activation of natural killer cells and immune cytoles, and depression of proliferation of B lymphocytes. So during those infection, formation of immunodeficiency syndrome, non-effective immune response, synthesis of antibodies. But antibodies don't recognize virus and it caused proliferation of the virus. During pathological process, it caused the formation of touched organs, for example, bilimbocytes, oropharyngeal epithelium, nature killer, monocytes, phagocytes, endothelium, epithelium cells, salivary gland cells, cervical cells, vascular endothelium, gastrointestinal epithelium. So they are target cells because virus penetrate to those cells and cause the destruction and proliferation of lymphocytes, destruction of epithelium, destruction of immune cells because it causes the formation immunodeficiency syndrome, destruction of monocytes is called the formation of immunodeficiency conditions, depression of phagocytosis, hyperplasia of salivary gland, yes, and so destruction of endothelium of capillaries because it caused the formation of rash on the skin, and destruction of epithelium of gastrointestinal system, which caused the formation syndrome of gastroenteritis. In reactivation of infection, in productive phase of infection, it causes the formation of new virions. Yes, and new virions infected new cells and cause the destruction of new cells. It causes dissemination of infection. So, and in the patient with immunodeficiency conditions, it causes the visceral form, general forms of infection. For example, in the cases of immunodeficiency conditions, it causes the formation of destruction of hepatocytes, for example, and formation of hepatitis with hyperbilirubinemia, with cytolysis. The virus causes the destruction of neurocytes and formation of neuropathia, and sometimes formation of syndrome Guillain-Barré, paresis and paralysis. Sometimes virus-infected alveoles and formation of pneumonia. Different clinical variants. Sometimes virus cause activation, massive activation of phagocytes and forms the gamma-phagocytosic syndrome in the patients. And uncontrolled proliferation of infected cells. So prolonged persistence of the virus causes uncontrolled proliferations and formations of malignant lymphoma and different localization of malignant lymphoma in the brain, in the lung, in the stomach, in intestinal, different localization. And virus block receptor of CD21, it causes inhibition of HLA antigen expression. It causes the disorders of activation of TH lymphocyte, T helper, yes, T helper, T lymphocyte helper. Inhibition of synthesis of immunoglobulins. Suppressions of CD8 lymphocytes, decreasing function of T lymphocytes, macrophages, neutrophils, decreasing or reduced synthesis of interleukins, for example, interleukin 1, interleukin 2, interferons alpha, interferons gamma and interleukin 12. So it's characterized by immunodeficiency conditions because interleukin 1 it is a primary cytokine which causes activation primary immune response, activation of phagocytosis and synthesis interleukin 2, Interleukin 2 activate proliferation of T lymphocytes and synthesis of antibodies and synthesis of interferons, decreasing synthesis of interferons alpha, interferons gamma, and interferons interleukin 12, and increasing of the synthesis of interleukin 27. So such pathogenesis, immune disorders, immune disturbances of the patients with infection mononucleosis. Then we speak about mechanism of protection against ABV, so virus Epstein-Barr, how immune system protection against those viruses. ABV, it is Epstein-Barr virus. So it causes activation of T lymphocytes with receptor CD16 and CD56 genotype, and increasing of synthesis interferon gamma. So, and those mediator cause activation mechanism of progression. For example, synthesis of proteins, chemokines, BGRFL. It is a homolog of interleukin 10. Suppressing of T lymphocytes, activation of GP 350, it is GP of membrane virus Epstein-Barr, which activate apoptosis of T lymphocytes and increasing of immunodeficiency syndrome. And depressing inhibition of synthesis chemokines, for example, MIP and PGE. So those chemokines responsible of activation of T lymphocytes. Sometimes the indication increasing T lymphocytes class 1, class 2, which causes the disorders of immunological control of HBV virus, virus Epstein-Barr. So sometimes decreasing of Th1 lymphocytes and increasing Th2 lymphocytes, discoordination of immune response, and disorders of immunological control of virus Epstein-Barr. Next, T lymphocytes, T cells, and in cases of immunodeficiency syndrome, cause the formation of reactivation of Epstein-Barr virus and cause the formation of persistence of the virus. And prolonged persistence of the virus cause the formation of malignant proliferation of lymphoid tissue. For example, formation of B cells lymphoma, Burkitt lymphoma, nasopharyngeal carcinoma, hemorrhagical and gemophagocytosis syndrome, and syndrome of Guillain-Barré. So, for example, localization of B lymphoma in the brain, in the stomach, in intestinal, in genital organs. Nasopharyngeal carcinoma localized in the nose and cause a very progressive malignization and dissemination to central nervous system. Gemophagocytosis syndrome characterized by massive activation of immune response and massive activation of phagocytes, which cause the destruction of blood cells, destruction of lymphocytes, phagocytes, thrombocytes, erythrocytes. So formation of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome, toxic shock, and polyorgans insufficiency. And the syndrome of Guillain-Barré characterized by destruction of non-endings, activation of autoimmune mechanism, synthesis of autoantibodies, which cause the destruction of nerve endings and formation of paresis and paralysis. Paresis and paralysis, which caused by virus Epstein-Barr. It is syndrome Guillain-Barré. So paresis paralysis may be cause formation of paralysis of respiratory center and death of the patients. What morphology picture of the patient, for example, hyperplasia of lymphatic nodes, hyperplasia of mesenchymal tissue in the liver, because activation of mesenchymal inflammatory syndrome, phagocytes, macrophages, synthesis of mediator and cause the proliferation of connective tissue, mesenchymal tissue, formation of gepatosplenic megaly, hyperplasia of lymphoid tissue of tonsils, formation of tonsillitis, and the indication purulent patch, necrotic patch on tonsils, and formation of lymphoid infiltration of different organs in visceral forms, disseminated forms, in the patients with AIDS infection, with immunodeficiency conditions, cause the formation of pneumonia, because formation of lymphoid infiltration of the lung, of the kidney, of central nervous system. Very seldom the indication rupture of the spleen, hemolysis of erythrocytes, thrombocytopenic purpura, and autoimmune disorders. Period of incubation is from 5 up to 43 days, last from 5 up to 43 days, and characterized by prolonged manifestation, yes, and prolonged clinic of infection, increasing of the temperature. During the first week, the temperature increasing during the last days of the week, and maybe atypical temperature, remittance temperature, maybe the temperature is more than 38 degrees. Then syndrome of acute tonsillitis, sore throat, increasing of hyperplasia of tonsils, hyperplasia of some mandibular lymphatic nodes, hyperemia, infiltration of mucus of tonsils, and formation of purulent patch in lacuna or necrotic patch on tonsils. In examination of the patient, we indication general lymphadenopathia, increasing of lymphatic nodes of different organs of different region of the patient. Sometimes we indicate massive conglomerate from lymphatic nodes on the neck. Pharyngitis, lymphadenopathia, gepatosplenomegaly, in blood picture we indication lymphocytosis increasing of indication of atypical mononuclears in blood. So it's characterized by indication rash on the skin sometimes, yes, because activation of autoimmune mechanism, increasing of permeability of blood vessels, and manifestation of rash on the skin. More often it is nodular rash, urticaria rash, sometimes papular rash on the skin. Sometimes rash appearance after antibiotic treatments. And we estimate those rash as complications of infection. And what about outcomes of infection, virus Epstein-Barr infection? It causes the formation of chronic forms because prolonged persistence of the virus causes, in cases of immunodeficiency conditions, cause the formation of chronic forms because virus keep in macroorganism. It keep in internal organs, in lymphatic nodes, in phagocytes, macrophages, so in non-favorable conditions, it cause reactivation of infection. So, and in chronic forms, we can reveal, for example, subfebrility temperature, prolonged fever, prolonged subfebrility temperature, general malaise, for example, sometimes catarrhal syndrome, rhinitis, pharyngitis, tonsillitis, sometimes lymphadenopathia, sometimes dyspepsia, diarrhea, because virus cause destruction mucous membrane of intestinal. So sometimes formation of combined infection, for example, combine virus Epstein-Barr and others herpetic virus, for example, cytomegalovirus, virus type B, and others. And sometimes it is there is chronic forms cause period of reactivation and latent phase of infection, phase of remission. Prolonged persistence of the virus causes formation of lymphoproliferation of lymphoid tissue and formation of malignant lymphoma, gemoblastosis, lymphogranulomatosis. Localization in the lung, brain, stomach, intestinal, genital organs. Activation of syndrome Guillain-Barré, it's a connection connect with destruction of nerve endings, synthesis of autoantibodies, immune complex, which cause the destruction of nerve endings and formation of neuropathy. There are mild, moderate, severe forms of syndrome Guillain-Barré, and in mild forms, the indication sometimes neuropathy. Mild forms of neuropathy. And the severe forms, it causes paresis, paralysis, and paresis of respiratory center and formation of acute respiratory insufficiency. Sometimes virus causes activation of multiple sclerosis because activation of autoimmune mechanism. Collagenosis, multiply sclerosis, because activation, synthesis of immune complex, autoantibodies, and destruction of nerve endings. And formation of malignant carcinoma and malignant proliferation of lymphoid cells and metastasis of carcinoma. What about diagnostic, laboratory diagnostic of infection? So we see immune enzyme analysis, ELISA methods, when we indication antibodies to the virus. So antibodies to the capsule antigen, yes, anti-VCA, IgM, and IgG. So the indication is the first days of infection. Next, antibodies to early antigen, antibodies to early antigen class M and G synthesis in the first days of infection. Antibodies to the nuclear antigen, anti-nuclear antigen class M and G synthesis on the fourth or fifth weeks of infection. And so polymerase reaction, when the indication virus in blood, in saliva, in urine, in lymphocytes, but more concentration of the virus in lymphocytes and in blood. So indication DNA of the virus, virus Epstein-Barr, characterize active replication of the virus. So sometimes in carriers of infection may be indication virus in blood too, but low concentration of the virus. Let's speak about treatments, infusion therapy, detoxication, because it is the patients with prolonged fever, syndrome intoxication, general malaise, those patients need of infusion therapy. At the severe forms, if the temperature is more than 41 degrees, we administer steroids, pulse therapy. Steroids, pulse therapy, for example, prednisolone 90 mg per day, or dexamethasone 8 mg per day during 5 days. Next moment, so we must administer antibiotic treatments, so sometimes macrolides, quinolones. If in the patient we indication purulent patch on tonsils, leukocytosis, we administer antibiotic treatments, cephalosporin sometimes. Antibiotic treatment lasts 7 days. For example, macrolides, for example, azithromycin, 500 milligram one time per day during 5 days. Or fluoroquinolones, for example, ciprofloxacin, 500 milligram two time per day during 7 days. During higher fever, we can administer non-steroids, for example, antipyretic. But we must remember that we never administer those patients ampicillin. So, because of those medicates cause toxic allergic reaction of the patient. Antihistaminic treatments, immunocorrections, for example, are in period of recovering after decreasing of the temperature, we administer interferonogens, for example, cyclophoron, amixin. We administer viferon, for example, isoprinosine, lycopid. So lycopid activate T lymphocytes and macrophages. Isoprinosine activate T lymphocytes. Cyclophoron activate synthesis of endogenic interferons. Amixin activate synthesis of endogenic interferon too. So it is immunocorrection therapy. At the severe forms, we administer immunoglobulins, antigerpetic immunoglobulins, or immunoglobulins of wide spectrum of activity. So we can administer the patient at the severe forms, for example, in syndrome, for example, gemophagocytosis syndrome, we administer steroids, megadoses of steroids, immunosuppressive therapy and treatments of disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome, plasma of blood, prothrombin complex, angioprotector to those patients. If it is a patient with syndrome of Guillain-Barré, we administer immunoglobulins to massive dose of immunoglobulins, because immunoglobulins connection antibodies of those patients, of antivirus of those patients, and activations of immune response and connection of the virus. Differentiation, we spoke about differentiation, tonsillitis, yes, hyperplasia of tonsils, you see different variants of angina, lacunar angina, catarrhal angina, follicular angina. In lacunar angina, we indicated purulent patch in lacuna. In catarrhal angina, catarrhal syndrome, hyperemia of tonsils, follicular angina, purulent elements in follicles. You see differentiation, for example, angina, pharyngite, tonsillite. Yes, angina, pharyngite, tonsillite, chronic tonsillite. You see hyperplasia of connective tissue, the destruction of lacuna, destruction of tonsils, deformation of lacuna, deformation of tonsils. In pharyngitis, we indication hyperplasia of lymphoid follicles of pharynx. In angina, we indication purulent patch on lacuna. Tonsillitis, yes, purulent patch on lacuna. Viral forces in viral infection, for example, in adenoviral infection. In enteroviral infection, we indicate hyperplasia of lymphoid follicles of forces. Tonsillitis, viral forces, we spoke about, yes, viral forces in influenza, in paragrip, syncytial infection, adenoviral infection, parasitic abscess, purulent infiltration of tonsils. Two. And infection mononucleosis. Yes, we see syndrome of tonsillitis, purulent patch or necrotic patch on tonsils. And general lymphadenopathy, you see increasing of lymphatic nodes of the neck, sometimes conglomerate of lymphatic nodes, increasing of lymphatic nodes of different groups. Symptoms of pharyngitis, maybe dry cough, sometimes nausea, sometimes splenomegaly, gepatomegaly, because hyperplasia of mesenchymal tissue of the internal organs. And so in blood we indication atypical mononuclears. In blood smear we indication atypical mononuclears. It is important for diagnostic of infection mononucleosis. But we must remember that atypical mononucleus we can indication in the patient with AIDS infection, adenoviral infection, cytomegalovirus infection too. Yes, in those infections we indicate atypical mononucleus. Sometimes formation of rash on the skin, exanthemas on the skin, the indication papular rash, macular rash, urticaria rash, sometimes itching of skin. Sometimes in the patient we indication hypertransaminasemia, hyperbilirubinemia, but there is no high level of bilirubin in those patients. Yes, sometimes increasing of bilirubin, for example, 50 or 60 micromol per liter. So a virus causes the destruction of hepatocytes, because it causes the disturbances of function of the liver and formation of not only hyperbilirubinemia, but syndrome of cetosis, and so increasing of alanine aminotransferase, aspartate aminotransferase, and symptoms hepatomegaly, and jaundice of skin, soft palate, subacteric sclera. So very often those patients sometimes hospitalized to infection departments with diagnosis of viral hepatitis. But we must differentiate viral hepatitis and infection mononucleosis. You see a purulent patch or necrotic patch in tonsils in infection mononucleosis. You see lymphadenopathy, block of lymphatic nodes on the neck. But we must differentiate infection mononucleosis and lymphogranulomatosis. Yes, the same clinic may be in gemoblastosis and lymphogranulomatosis too. So sometimes biopsia of lymphatic nodes. Block of lymphatic nodes. Block of lymphatic nodes. Massive lymphadenopathy. Rash on the skin. Macula, papular rash, urticaria rash. It is manifestation of toxic allergic syndrome in the patient with infection mononucleosis. You see atypical mononuclears. Atypical mononuclears and the indication in blood smear in the patients with infection mononucleosis. Differentiation with candidosis, it is opportunistic infection and white patch on candidosic patch on fossas, mucous membrane, tongue. Candidosis. Candidosic patch on fossa, tonsils, ovule, mucous membrane. So we must remember about AIDS infection and manifestation of opportunistic infection or after antibiotic treatments, reactivation of candidosis. Candidosis 2. So, diphtheria, the indication fibrinic patch on tonsils. Local form, spread form, toxic form of diphtheria. Massive gray fibrinic patch on tonsils. Oropharyngeal diphtheria, you see, character of patch in those infection. Spread forms of diphtheria, you see, spread fibrinic patch on soft palate. A spread of forms of diphtheria, 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 you see, hypertoxic forms of diphtheria, edema of neck in toxic forms of diphtheria. Edema of neck in toxic forms of diphtheria. Chronic tonsillitis, hyperplasia and destruction of tonsils and lacuna of tonsils. Deformation of tonsils and deformation of lacuna of tonsils. May be compensation and decompensation forms of chronic tonsillitis. And decompensation tonsillitis characterized by formation of Tachy tokens, myocarditis, nephritis, arthritis, and rheumatic fever. Chronic tonsillitis. Chronic tonsillitis, enteroviral infection, yes, gerpangina, vesical rash on soft palate. Enteroviral infection, we must remember that in enteroviral infection may be gastroenteritis, serosal meningitis, exanthems, conjunctivitis, rash on the skin. And enteroviral infection caused by Coxsackie viral and enteroviral. Necrotic angina. Szymanowski plot in sun, characterized by subfebrility temperature and necrotic patch on tonsils, then rejection of necrosis and formation of ulcers. Bubon's form of tularemia or pharyngeal tularemia and contact with rodents, alimentary mechanism of transmissions, formation of necrosis of tonsils, necrotic patch on tonsils, and formation of bubons of regional lymphatic nodes, submandibular lymphatic nodes, big lymphatic nodes. Now, my colleagues, we spoke about differentiation of tonsillitis, we spoke about angina, we spoke about differentiation of angina and others infection which accompanied syndrome of tonsillitis. Thank you for your time.